what's up you guys? It's Dorothy and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to go into chapter 91 of I'm Glad My Mom Died by Jeanette McCurdy, which is the last chapter to this book, which means we will be officially done with it after this video. Sorry, my dog took a receipt and was trying to chew it. Anyways, let's get right into this video. This video may contain sensitive topics and foul language. If you do not wish to continue, please click off the video now. You have been warned. Chapter 91. Hi, Mom. I almost say out loud, but I stop myself because I don't want to look crazy to the other mourners around me. Mourner? Singular, actually. There's only one, and it's the same guy I see here every time. He sits in a lawn chair with a sun umbrella over him, playing soft rock from a stereo and staring at the headstone of who I assume to be his former wife. I look at Mom's headstone. There are about 20 adjectives on it because everyone in the family had adjective pitches and nobody was willing to forsake theirs. We've got to include playful, Grandpa insisted. Why does nobody like brave? Brave is a good word, Grandma wailed. So we just crammed all of the words on there. Even Mom's place of death is cluttered. This is my first time visiting Mom's grave since her birthday last July. My visits have become less frequent throughout the years, even though I promised Mom, per her request, that I would visit her grave every day. In the beginning, I visited once a week and felt guilty about it, like it wasn't enough. But with time and reality, the visits have become less and less, and so has the guilt. I sit cross-legged in front of her grave. I take a longer look at the words on her headstone. Brave, kind, loyal, sweet, loving, graceful, strong, thoughtful, funny, genuine, hopeful, playful, insightful, and on and on. Was she, though? Was she any of those things? The words make me angry. I can't look at them any longer. Why do we romanticize the dead? Why can't we be honest about them, especially Mom's? They're the most romanticized of anyone. Moms are saints, angels by merely existing. No one could possibly understand what it's like to be a mom. Men will never understand. Women with no children will never understand. No one but moms know the hardship of motherhood. And we non-moms must heap nothing but praise upon moms because we lowly, pitiful non-moms are mere peasants compared to the goddesses we call mothers. Maybe I feel this way now because I viewed my mom that way for so long. I had her up on a pedestal, and I know how determinal that pedestal was to my well-being in life. The pedestal kept me stuck, emotionally stunted, living in fear, dependent in the near-consistent state of emotional pain, and without the tools to even identify that pain, let alone deal with it. My mom didn't deserve her pedestal. She was a narcissist. She refused to admit she had any problems, despite how destructive those problems were to our entire family. My mom emotionally, mentally, and physically abused me in ways that will forever impact me. She gave me breast and vaginal exams until I was 17 years old. These exams made my body stiff with discomfort. I felt violated, yet I had no voice, no ability to express it. I was conditioned to believe any boundary I wanted was a betrayal of her, so I stayed silent, cooperative. When I was 6 years old, she pushed me into a career I didn't want. I'm grateful for the financial stability that that career has provided me, but not much else. I was not equipped to handle the entertainment industry and all of its competitiveness, rejection, stakes, harsh realities, fame. I needed that time, those years, to develop as a child, to form my identity, to grow. I can never get those years back. She taught me an eating disorder when I was 11 years old, an eating disorder that robbed me of joy and any moment of free-spiritedness that I had. She never told me my father was not my father. Her death left me with more questions than answers, more pain than healing, and many layers of grief. The initial grief from her passing, then the grief of accepting her abuse and exploitation of me, and finally the grief that surfaces now that I miss her and start to cry, because I do still miss her and start to cry. I miss her pep talks. Mom had a knack for finding just the right thing in a person to get them to light up and believe in themselves. I miss her childlike spirit. Mom had an energy that could at times be so endearing, even captivating. And I miss when she was happy. It didn't happen as often as I would have liked it. It didn't happen as often as I tried to force it to happen, but when she was happy, it was infectious. Sometimes when I miss her, I start to fantasize about what life would be like if she were still alive, and I imagine that maybe she'd have apologized and we'd have wept in each other's arms and promised each other we'd start fresh. Maybe she'd support me on having my own identity, my own hopes and dreams and pursuits, but then I realize I'm just romanticizing the dead in the same way I wish everyone else wouldn't. Mom made it very clear she had no interest in changing. If she were still alive, she'd still be trying her best to manipulate me into being who she wants me to be. I'd still be purging or restricting or binging or some combination of the three, and she'd still be endorsing it. I'd still be forcing myself to act miserably, going through the motions of performing on shiny sitcoms. How many times can you pratfall over a carpet or sell a line you don't believe in before your soul dies? There's a good chance I would have had a complete and public mental breakdown by this point. I'd still be deeply unhappy and severely mentally unhealthy. I look at the words again: brave, kind, loyal, sweet, loving, graceful. I shake my head. I don't cry. The Doobie Brothers, What a Fool Believes, starts playing from the Sad Man stereo. I stand up, wipe the dirt off my jeans, and walk away. I know I'm not coming back. That is the end of this book, and what a journey that was. I have no words. It was emotional, raw, and really intense and revealing of so much of her life that I don't think a lot of us would have known otherwise. But yeah, I will see you guys in one of the next videos for your next book journey. So